Hey, this is Mike. Have you ever driven past a dealership and just saw an awesome truck on the lot and you're like, man, that just gets your heart pumping? Well, that's what happened today when I stopped by and pulled in the parking lot at Hyatt Buick GMC in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, and I saw this 2015 GMC Canyon. And I was like, man, you don't really see the mid-size trucks too much anymore. So when I see one of these, I really get excited. I like trucks. There's something about trucks, the utility of them, the looks, and, well, there's a whole bunch of reasons why I get excited. I'm sure you can understand that. But anyways, let's check it out. It's a 2015 GMC Canyon in red, as you can probably notice. And this one is equipped with the all-terrain package, the Z71 all-terrain package, which gives it a little bit better off-road capabilities. And so it does have the 17-inch Kevlar Enforced Wrangler Goodyear tires, and it's for the additional off-road capabilities. And check out those wheels. Aluminum wheels, aluminum alloy wheels with some kind of like the bright part right here, and then you've got the gray on the inside, which gives it a kind of a sportier look. It also has the off-road tubular side steps. I think they look awesome, and you can tell they're really super sturdy when you step on them. There's no giving at all. It feels like part of the frame, which this one does have the full box frame. It's a super solid truck. So here in the front, it has the projector tubes powered by halogen headlights and fog lights. And you've got that shiny grille across the front. And that shiny red with the chrome. Yeah, and there's a lot to say about this particular truck too, besides just that. So one of the features it has, which I'm gonna take advantage of right now, see, here's the key. That's the key fob, I mean. It's got the GMC on the back. The actual key is here. So let me take the key fob. I'm gonna make sure it's locked by pushing that button and then immediately pushing this, and this is the remote start. You push and hold it. You do have to make sure it's push lock, push that and hold it, and it starts up. So now this started up the 3.6 liter V6 engine that this particular one has. That is an upgrade. You can get the four cylinder, but this one has the V6. So it has the extra capability of the stronger engine. See, it has the disc brakes in the front and the back. And it also has the splash guards, mud flaps, whatever you want to call them, already on the truck. You can see it has a little one there in the front and a larger one in the back. So let's check out the passenger side. So here's the passenger side door. As you can see, it's all black. It does have some red stitching here to match the outside of the truck. You also have like a carbon fiber, looks like more than likely imitation carbon fiber here. And you know, it's soft to the touch in most places. Got a bottle holder there. You also have some places to put your cell phone and stuff, and a small pocket down there. It does have the power seat with the lumbar support, and to recline the seat, you use that lever there. It does have the leather trim seats here with the cloth inserts, and you've got the all-terrain badge on the back of the seat, and then you've got like a kind of like a carbon fiber look. I don't know if you can pick that up to the seats around the outside. Maybe you can see it better over here. See, it has like a carbon fiber look where it looks like it's woven together, like the carbon fiber. Pretty neat. And then you got the red stitching, of course. There's the glove compartment. Now, you do have the red stitching and the soft leather type material on the dash. All right, so this is actually also a door. This opens up. which gives you plenty of room there to access the front or the back. And the back seats are kind of small, but they are, you know, this is it's not a four-door truck, so it, you know, it's just kind of like an additional, I guess it is a four-door truck technically, but you know, you have to open the front door before the back. But you do have the small seats. It looks like mostly for small people or children, or, you know, not huge. And now, you know, if you were to put the seat all the way up, now the seat was all the way back. Let's just kind of see if we were to put this seat up a little bit more to accommodate a little bit taller person. That would probably work in a pinch. And you see, you do have the full leather seats here in the back, and they are quite vertical there, and they do accommodate child safety seats. You can see it does have the latch system, and also it mentions that there's the headrest part right here. You can take that out and you can insert it here to give it an additional distance out for to properly seat a certain child seats. So that's something to consider. Also, pulling this, I have to do this, there we go, it does have some little storage underneath the seat, so you can, you know, you can put stuff under there and also use the seat as well. You have cup holders back here, there's your seat belts, and you also have like a little storage space there. Your jack is behind this little cover. Two USB ports, these I think are mostly for charging, but you also have a 12 volt charger here, and you got a little storage pocket for putting stuff for the back seat drivers. So you got the hooks there for hangers, get the interior lights. So that's pretty much the back seat there. And you see you do have the privacy glass for the rear passengers. All right, moving on. This is pretty cool back here. This is the back of the truck, of course, but also you can see a couple things. The bumper has these steps here, so you can literally step up on this right here and get in the vehicle. So like say when the tailgate, you see how it slowly comes down. I'm gonna do that again. See, when you unlatch it, slowly comes down, so you don't even have to touch it. Also, it is assisted going up, so you can just barely just a slight amount of effort to lift the tailgate up. But once you have it down, you know, you can step here, you can step right there on the bumper and jump right in. And you know, you can use this as a brace or whatever and jump right in the truck. You can do your thing, and then you know, it makes it easier to access the back of the truck. Now, this is a locking tailgate, and one of the reasons why it's locking, you know, you don't want people to access your stuff in the back, but also this is a removable tailgate, so it is an easy removable tailgate. You can lift it up to a certain point, and you can pull this side out. It'll pull out of its hinge on the other side, and of course you have to disconnect this, but it's not a big deal doing that. And you can remove the tailgate, so if you need some while you're working, sometimes it's easier to load and unload a truck when the tailgate is not in the way. So that's an awesome feature. I think it's pretty cool that they were to include that easy. I've taken the tailgate off my truck several times, and usually, you know, it requires wrenches and bolts and ratchets and all that stuff. So I think this is a really good idea to, without any tools, be able to remove your tailgate. You also have a backup camera there. See the little camera lens, and then of course you can lock the tailgate. The towing package consists of the reset chair there, but you also have the two plug-ins, the 4 and 7-way plugs, so you're pretty much covered on pretty much any kind of you know, hookup. Those taillights look pretty sharp. Now here's the fuel door. You just push this, opens up the fuel door. It is a large fuel door, and it has an additional space here. And I'm curious if that is something that they're include maybe a DEF in a diesel option in the future. I'm not sure why this is a large door and why they have this additional space, but maybe if you know, you can let me know. But also, when you take the cap off, you have this plastic string here, and you can hang it right across there to where it's away from your shiny paint, keep it from, you know, scratching it and scuffing it, that kind of stuff. All right, so let's take a look in here. There's the inside of the driver's door, which is pretty much a mirror of the passenger side, except for it has a few more buttons. You know, of course you got your speaker there, but right here is your power windows for both sides, your side mirror controls. You just gotta choose which side you want. And then your door lock controls are here. And so pretty much gives you a little bit more options there. Now, these buttons here, this is a four-wheel drive truck, and so this right here is your dimmer switch for your interior lights. This button is for your headlights. You have an automatic mode. You also have your parking lights and then your headlights. And you can also push this button here for your fog lights to come on. And then this is your four-wheel drive controls. It's just as simple as turning a knob to put yourself in four-wheel drive. And you can also put it in the automatic mode to where you can, you don't necessarily need the four-wheel drive constantly, but you want it to, automatically turn on at just a moment's notice, and it will detect whether it needs the four-wheel drive or not, and you can just switch it to automatic mode. Or you could just put it in four-wheel drive high. You can see the little arrow there. It has a four-wheel drive high, which is up, four-wheel drive low, which is down. And then you've got the seat there with the power adjustments as well as the lumbar support. And then you've got the same door here, and you can see that it does have, a bottle holder and stuff like that, some slight amount of storage space for the rear passengers. And this side, this is a little bit different. It does not have the child seat extender here, so it's just showing you right there that it's not for the child seat. Go ahead and shut this door, and I'm gonna hop in. Get the key out of my pocket. The reason why, it's already started, but I still have to use the key to turn everything on. So you notice the air conditioner is on, but you notice the screens are not turned on and the vehicle's not ready to drive. So I didn't mean to take the key, put in the ignition, and turn it on. So now everything turns on. I'm gonna turn the fan down a little bit. It is a pretty warm day, so I'm gonna leave the air conditioner on.
Connected by OnStar's high-speed 4G connection. Press the blue OnStar button to learn more.
Okay, so that's that. Now, you notice in that, when you have the voice commands, it will dim out the radio, but it also dim out the fan speed. So if I had the fan speed really high, it would lower that in order to hear it. Because I don't know if you noticed when I first got in, it's pretty loud, the fan, when it's full blast. Right now, it's not too bad. All right, so this one does have the leather-wrapped, hand-stitched leather-wrapped steering wheel with the red stitching to match the rest of the vehicle. And you got the GMC badge there. You've got your cruise control on this side. Now on the back of the steering wheel, it has a volume button on this side, so you're cruising along, you can adjust the volume, and you can change the stations on this side. All right, it will change if you have favorite set. This one doesn't have that, so I'm gonna just turn the volume. Now if you were had like a playing music through a media device, like say an iPod or your phone or something, you could cycle through the different tracks using the buttons on the very back of the steering wheel. There is, I don't know if you can see that. So, in addition, all the buttons on the front has buttons on the back. Safety feature. Cruise control. Now on this side, you have voice recognition. Now there's a lot of different commands that you can use on the voice recognition. I'm going to push it, and I'm going to just kind of give you, it'll kind of give you a little bit of a demo.
Command, please.
Help.
You can say phone, audio, navigation, weather, or OnStar. To call a number quicker, say call followed by the number, like this, call 555-1212. To quickly change what is playing on an audio system, say commands like tune to FM 101.1 or play followed by the name of an artist, album, or song. or to enter a destination, say navigation.
Cancel.
Goodbye.
Now, I don't know if you noticed that the voice in this truck is a little bit less robotic sounding than some of the other vehicles, and you know, I think that's a little bit more user friendly. But the whole voice command thing is it's something that once you get used to using, if it's something you're not used to and you're kind of like, you know, kind of wary and you're not really you think you might not want to use it, give it a try at least a few times, because it is a very good safety feature in addition to just convenient feature. It is a safety feature because it keeps you your eyes on the road, just like your hands on the steering wheel here with the volume and stuff. It keeps your eyes on the road, your hands on the wheel, and you can make all kinds of different you can make phone calls, you can change the navigation to a certain address, you can go to a certain station, you can do a bunch of stuff using the voice recognition, and you don't have to move your hands off the steering wheel or take your eyes off the road. So that's a very good safety feature. I would strongly recommend getting a vehicle with it, one, and two, learning how to use it to its fullest potential. So this is the button to hang up on somebody if they're you don't want to talk to them anymore. And these buttons here, the arrow and the little check mark, correspond with, right between the gauges, you'll see a little screen, and you can see it's got the normal gauges. You got your RPMs, you got your speed, fuel gauge, and all that good stuff, temperature. But that little screen in the middle gives you a ton of information. I'm just going to kind of scroll through to show you. I'm going to push the left arrow, and it shows a menu there. So now that the menu's popped up, I can go ahead and kind of scroll through. So I can scroll. I got trips. I got fuel range, I got oil life, tire pressure, and then it goes back to the miles per gallon. So let's go to the navigation and let's see what that looks like. So once you have a route entered, it's going to give you some, it's going to kind of give you the pointers like turn left and turn right and stuff like that here on the screen, as well as the map on the big screen. You can change the settings on this screen to where it shows different things. Example, right now at the bottom left, it has it has an S. You see that little S? That means the vehicle is facing south. You can change that to if you wanted to have like the distance to empty and that kind of stuff. So, pretty cool. So I'm gonna go back out of here, go into settings so you can see what I'm talking about. You can change the units, like say if you want to change it to kilometers and stuff like that. There is a speed warning to where it will alert you if you are speeding. I'm going to go ahead and turn that on so you can set a certain speed. Okay, let's go into there. Okay, so that's all that there. But basically, you know, I can go through this forever. But there's lots of information in that screen to where it's not necessarily you have to use everything, but it is there in case you want to use it. That's the main point. All right, so moving on to the big screen. By the way, this does have the Bose premium sound system, which sounds awesome. But you got to experience that for yourself. It's kind of hard to relay that through a camera sometimes. So here is the big touchscreen. You got temperature outside. You can see it's kind of warm out. You see the time, but also you see all these icons, and it's kind of like a computer in that you have different icons that do different things. So when you have this as the home screen, so this little house there, that means home. So this is your home screen. You can go into the audio, which shows you what your radio is doing. Now you can change like AM, FM, satellite radio, that kind of stuff. And go back to the home screen. Once you pair your cell phone, right now there's no cell phone paired, but you also, once you have it paired, you'll have your phone book with your contacts, recent calls, you have a keypad, you'll be able to handle voicemail, and you do voice commands, and you can have multiple phones. It does work on a priority system. Going back home, there's your navigation, and right now it's showing you the map. Now you can zoom out, kind of get your bearings, look at the map. You also have an up down different views from, you know, where you're at.
But you can also, hitting the destination, will give you the ability to put type in a specific address. And you can get them out of your contacts, which is pretty cool. You can put in an address, go to recent places, all that cool stuff. So let me hit the home button again. Let's go back home. There's tons of settings where you can set up the screen the way you want it. Pandora is something that you would have to use with your cell phone once you pair it. If you have the Pandora app on your phone, you can listen to music through the Bluetooth system using Pandora. Weather, this is connected through your satellite and your OnStar and satellite radio, that kind of stuff. It all put pieces things together and gives you more information. So now you're seeing there's a weather map now, and you can see this cloud is going to come rushing over there and rain on me. But so you get an idea of what the where the clouds are. You can also get an hourly, a 36 hour, a daily forecast there, so that way you can kind of plan your trips or whatever while you're out on the town or whatever. So let me go back home, and there's your text messages. And it is a voice command. You can also, you have to pair a device, but it'll, from what I understand, it gives you commands that you can say, and then that way you can respond to voice. You can respond to text, use your voice, and then that way it's, like I said, it's a safety feature. So you can see lots of stuff you can do on the screen. You don't have to constantly cycle through everything while you're driving, but the things are there, and you're able to control all these with your voice. So very handy. And there's your different controls. Now you do have the volume control here and the radio there, and you can your radio, and you got your home, you got a back button to get out of certain screens and cycle through stations or stuff like that. Now this media button, this is for playing music through either your Bluetooth device like your cell phone, or an iPod or some kind of portable device. So your connectivity for that is here. There's a USB port and there's a auxiliary input to where you can play, hook just about anything up to the system and play through the media portion of the radio. Climate control is down here. You got your fan speed. If you got your temperature, you can put it on automatic and just adjust the temperature and just roll with it. You can also fine tune where you want the air to blow, defrosters front and rear, air conditioning, recycle the air. Now, just want to mention that recycling the air, it's good for keep cooling the same air and make it colder and colder and colder, but it's also handy for like outside odors. Like if there's a truck in front of you on the highway, or if there's some kind of smelly thing in the air outside, push that button and it'll keep the outside air from coming in the cabin, and it kind of completely just stops that odor from coming in the vehicle. So I just want to mention that there's a couple uses there. Now, like I said, it does recirculate the inside air, so you're not getting any fresh air. So on a long trip, you want to consider that, maybe roll the windows down occasionally to get some fresh air in the vehicle. So down here, you do have a trailer tow button here. So like if you're pulling a trailer, you want to go ahead and engage that, because it tells the truck, the computer system, that you're pulling something, and to hold the shift points a little bit longer, maybe not go in the extreme high gears, that kind of stuff. Your traction control, you can turn that off if you want to. Usually you don't do that unless you're stuck and you're trying to spin tires or rock the truck and get it out of a stuck position. Your four-way flashers are here. This is your bed cargo light, and it illuminates, it shines from the back of the top back of the cabin, and it illuminates the entire bed. So this is a really handy feature at night. Now you do have a downhill descent button there. You can go down this is only for off-road now. It's if you're on a slippery grade and you're going downhill, you can let that do it, turn that on and let it do its thing. You won't even have to touch the brake pedal. It'll use the ABS system to keep you at a real slow but steady rate down without too aggressively starting and stopping and causing yourself to slide. So that's a pretty cool feature. Heated seats. You got the heated seat buttons here. This is for your back. This is for both the bottom of the seat and your back. Same thing on the passenger side. Little itty bitty pocket there. Not sure what it's used for. I don't know, maybe a few quarters or something, but it is a very small pocket. So there's a big pocket there, and I'll give you an idea. And I like this. Here's my cell phone. So there's my cell phone. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in here because that's probably where I would put it when I get in this truck, is right there in the cup holder. It does have a nice place to where you can put it. Now, only problem with that is, where do I put my cup? So I guess I could stand it up like that and put my cup there. That's an option. Or I can put it down in there. That's a good spot. It actually goes all the way down flush, so that's pretty cool. It's a little bit hard to get back out when I do that. So, but you also have this pocket here, which is pretty handy for putting a cell phone. And actually, I think I like that place better. So this does have some really good places to put cell phones. I do have a Note 4, so it's a little bit larger than the average cell phone, but that gives you an idea of, you know, the different places that you can put the cell phones. Of course, you have places on the door, but I don't really like to do that. All right, so here's the shifter, and the shifter does a few things besides, you know, put it in different gears. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in reverse. So now it's in reverse. You can see the backup camera pops up here. And you see those lines? Well, I'm going to turn the steering wheel. You can see I'm turning it. You see those lines moving. That gives you an estimated trajectory of the truck. But also an estimated width of the size of the truck. Because this is a kind of a wide angle lens back there, so it kind of distorts things on the edges. So when you're backing up, this just gives you an estimated where you're going to go, your trajectory. Also, your width, your size of your vehicle as you back up, because it looks kind of wide there, but you see as you back up, it's going to fill up a smaller space. Now you can see this does give you the view of all the way from the bumper to the sky, so it gives you a really good view. Backing up to a trailer is awesome with this. You can just back right up first try, no help, and it's a lifesaver in a lot of ways. It saves a lot of your time getting in and out of the truck. But anyways, you also not hitting your truck, hitting the trailer with your truck, gives you a really, really good ability to back up and get the right place. And a safety feature, of course. Now, continuing on with the shifter, you got your neutral, you got your drive, but you also down here, you got your manual. So when I put it in manual, you'll see, that it pops up here. It says M1. I don't know if you can see that. Let me zoom in a little bit. So you can see it says M1. So right here, right there on the side of the shifter, where your thumb goes, it has a plus and minus. And so basically when you got it in, let me find it again. Okay, M1, you can push the button and you can cycle through the gears as you're driving. Now it's not going to let you go too far out of range because it might mess up the truck. But it will give you the ability to adjust the shift points a little bit more precise to what you want them to be. So it's very simple. It is a manual type mode. So that's what that does. And you want to make sure that when you get in the truck, you don't, just don't slap it down a manual and drive. You want to make sure you only go there when you need to. You want to keep it in drive most of the time. And you can with the manual downshift when you're going down a steep hill or whatever, and you don't want to ride the brakes. So you can use some engine braking. So pretty cool feature. Now here's your center console. It does have the stitching here, and you know, it is pretty comfortable, very soft. You see it gives pretty good. And this lifts up, and you also have another USB port in here and a place to put a bunch of junk. And this little groove right here is so you can put wires in and out of this compartment, so you can put a wire out through there, so when you close that, it doesn't pinch the wires or anything. All right, so up here is your rear view mirror, and it does have the OnStar buttons with the assistance button on the left and the emergency button on the right. It is an auto dim rear view mirror. There's a little light sensor there, and that gives you the that gives you the feature to where if you're driving and somebody behind you has their bright lights on, it's gonna dim your rear view mirror slightly to avoid you getting blinded, but you still be able to see through the mirror. All right, so up here, you've got a tap light so you can quick access light for, you know, one side or the other. You also have the ability to turn off all the interior lights, even when the door is open. You can turn on all the interior lights like that, or you can have it in the middle towards just the door. When the door opens, it'll turn on the interior lights. There's a place to put your shades up here. It is a little, it has some padding on the inside. There's your microphone for your Bluetooth system. Visor has lights and mirrors. Same thing on that side. All right, let's take a look at this window sticker, see if you can get an idea of what's on it. All right, GMC, four-wheel drive, extended cab, SLE. Now, some of these features on this side will be replaced by the optional stuff on that side. Just keep that in mind. I'm going to probably do a video showing people how to read window stickers, because if you don't read them frequently, you might get confused. All right, let's take a look back here. See what the back window looks like. It is a solid back glass. All right, let's take a look under the hood. Check out that 3.6 liter. You notice how quiet it was when in the side of the truck too. As soon as I opened up the door, all this noise happened. Alrighty. All we gotta do is put a finger, move it to the right, lift it up a few inches, and it goes up the rest of the way by itself. Alright, it's covered up with plastic, I know. It's a 3.6 liter V6. It does have the VVT and the direct injection system. The VVT is, if you're not familiar with that, it gives basically, I have a video what is VVT, and Matt, the engineer student, goes into the specifics, but basically what it does, it gives you more power and uses less fuel. And same thing with the direct injection, 3,000 pounds of pressure, basically it squirts the gas into the cylinder and gives it a really good mist to where it can easily be burned without any very very little extra gas coming out the tailpipe or whatever. But anyway, those are kind of real simple layman's terms to explain it. You see you got your GMC embossed there. Alright, can't really hardly see the engine. We got a bunch of plastic in the way, but unfortunately that's the trend. Alright, there you have it. 2015 GMC Canyon. Awesome truck, tons of features. They are kind of not really easy to find right now, so I'm glad I was able to see this one and check it out and share it with you. So, and if you don't mind, if you can help support my channel, and by that I mean yes. Hit the donate button. Send me some money. I really appreciate it. I need your help to grow my channel, get better quality content, have more of a variety of vehicles on here. And also, you know, of course, if you don't have any money, don't worry about it, because you can help me in another way, and that is sharing my videos with friends and family. Like, subscribe, comment, and that kind of stuff helps me as well. All right, well, thank you for watching. I know your time is precious. And also thank you to Hyatt Buick GMC in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, for allowing me to check out this truck. And this is the only one they have on the lot right now. They're pretty popular and they go pretty fast. So anyways, thanks for watching. See you next time.